Guten Morgen, es sind dann der Prof von Luxembourgish with Anne. Now learn in this lesson 10 phrases Luxembourgish native speakers use a lot in everyday life conversations, in social gatherings, at work, with the family, and so on. So I really recommend that you listen to these phrases so that you get used how they are pronounced, and then don't hesitate to use them as well in conversations. Now this is part 2 of these 10 must-know phrases, and if you haven't read the lesson, you can read the part 1 on my blog, and the link is below this video. Warst du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! To say in Luxembourgish, do you have any plans? This is Hut dir etwas vier. Now listen and repeat after me. Hut dir etwas vier. Now use Hut dir when talking to several people or to a couple of friends. But if you're only talking to one person you know very well, or to one person in an informal situation, you would rather use hörst du etwas vier plus a point in time. So use hörst du etwas vier or hört dir etwas vier, so plus a point in time. I will list here just 2 examples. If you want more examples, you can read, of course, the lesson on my blog or download as well the PDF copy. Prat? Los. Hörst du the weekend etwas vier? Hörst du the weekend etwas vier? Or when talking to several people or to a couple of friends. Hört dir den Abend etwas vier? Hut dir den Abend etwas vier. Let's move on. Wat hast du gesagt? So, what did you say? It sounds like this. Wat hast du gesagt? Now listen and repeat. Wat hast du gesagt? Now, this is a question which is often used by native speakers. So when they have just listened to a conversation, but they didn't understand everything, they didn't catch everything, or they just misheard something, then you can say, wat hast du gesagt? So it is more polite than just saying, wat? Okay? And if you are in a formal situation, you should rather say, wat hast du gesagt? Wat? Hut dir gesagt. And in natural spoken Luxembourgish, it sounds like this. Wat hut dir gesagt? Wat hut dir gesagt? Great. Let's move on. To say, oh, that's a pity, or that's really a pity, you say in Luxembourgish, da das aber schuld. Now listen and repeat, da das aber schuld. More naturally, that does have a shirt. Now this is really to emphasize that something is really, really a pity. You can of course use the short form shirt, shirt. But to be more polite, you would say that as ever shirt. For example, a colleague or a friend asks you, gehst du mit an der Restaurant? And you can answer, dit mal lied, schon kein Zeit. And your colleague would answer, da das aber schuld. That's really a pity. Da das aber schuld. Sentence number 4. My body part hurts is in Luxembourgish schon plus your body part weh. Schon, weh. So this is a natural way to say that you don't feel well. For example, schon der Bauch weh. Schon der Bauch weh. Schon der Rick weh. Schon der Rick weh. Or schon der Kopf weh. Schon der Kopf weh. Okay, so use schon plus your body part weh. Now to say that in general that you don't feel very well, You can say, et as mir nicht gut. Et as mir nicht gut. Now, use this expression if you don't want to specifically say like schon de Bauchweh or schon de Mauweh. And et as mir nicht gut tends to be used more when you have stomach problems, okay? So for example, you can say et as mir nicht gut when you just went to the restaurant, you ate maybe too much or it was not good and you suddenly feel sick or bad. Then you would rather say et as mir nicht gut. Das mir nicht gut. So in natural spoken Luxembourgish it sounds like this. Das mir nicht gut. Good. Let's move on. Sentence number 6. What does that mean is, wat heisht dat? Wat heisht dat? Wat heisht dat? Now, naturally, it sounds like this. Wat heisht dat? Now, listen and repeat after me. Wat heisht dat? So, as you can hear, the final T of heisht is not pronounced. Wat heisht dat? Now, this is a great way to use when you don't understand something that is written or the background of a situation. For example, you need a further explanation of something someone just said. Or for example, that person has just gone and you can't ask that person, wat hast du gesagt? Or wat hat dir gesagt? Then you can ask another person, wat heisht dat? Wat heisht dat? Great. Satz Nummer 7. Sentence Number 7. I need to go to. So let's say you need to go somewhere to accomplish a daily task. For example, you need to go to the bank. You have to say in Luxembourgish, ich muss plus your location, gehen. Ich muss gehen. For example, I need to go to the bank is ich muss op die Bank gehen. So use the verb müssen here. So ich muss op die Bank gehen. But it is not only used when you want to say that you need to accomplish a daily task, but as well if you need to go to the toilet. For example, you can say ich muss op Toilet gehen. Ich muss auf Toilette gehen. And this is quite a polite form. So if you need to go to a location, use ich muss plus your location gehen. So how would you say I need to go to the doctor? Yes, this is ich muss bei den Doktor gehen. Ich muss bei den Doktor gehen. And now be careful because you will see now the next sentence. This is a little bit different. This is if you want to say I need something. I need something is in Luxembourgish ich brauch plus the thing you need. Okay? Here use the verb brauchen. So I need something is ich brauch. For example, I need more time is ich brauch mehr Zeit and pronounce it brauch. Ich brauch mehr Zeit. Or for example, I need a new coat is ich brauch einen neuen Mantel. Ich brauch einen neuen Mantel. So make the difference between I need to go to a location where you have to say ich muss gehen and I need something is ich brauch plus your thing. Great. Ich soll dir Bescheid. I will let you know. Ich soll dir Bescheid. Now, this is the informal way to tell someone, I will let you know. But you can as well say, ich soll ihr Bescheid. And this is the formal way. Ich soll ihr Bescheid. Now, this is commonly used in emails, in conversations. For example, a friend is asking you, kannst du auf mein Party? But you haven't made up your mind yet. Then you can say, ich weiß noch nicht, ich soll dir Bescheid. Oder ich sohn dir nur Bescheid. I will let you know tomorrow. Ich sohn dir nur Bescheid. Or to say to someone, I will let you know as soon as possible is, ich sohn dir so sehr wie möglich Bescheid. Ich sohn dir so sehr wie möglich Bescheid. So, ich sohn dir Bescheid. Or more formal, ich sohn ihr Bescheid. Let's finish this lesson with the last must-know phrase, and this is by eyes. And more naturally, by eyes. By eyes. So by eyes is the simple way to say at our home, at our house or at our place. Beispiel, by eyes geht es sonst immer panischer. By eyes geht es sonst immer panischer. So this is really to express that at our house, at our home, at our place, when you are a family, for example. But if you just if you are just living alone and you just want to say at my place, this is by mir, okay? And more generally, you can use this expression by eyes if you want to say in our area or in our city, in our country. For example, you can say by eyes als et sondes immer ganz ruhig. So at in our area, it is always very quiet on Sundays. By eyes als et sondes immer ganz ruhig. Great. I hope that this lesson was useful. Don't forget to read the full transcript with a lot of more examples on my blog and as well to download the PDF copy. So just to practice again and again. Thank you for watching, and if you like this lesson, press the like button. Merci.